I have noticed in these triumphant Nazi celebrations a new feature I never used to see. Behind the band and its following of brown-shirted storm troops, there is now a long tail of civilian flag wavers who never used to march with them.
It was the 25th of February. These Nazi loyalists were assembled in Munich for what was billed as the biggest oath-taking in human history. If you knew what was good for you, you joined them.
Der Programmverkündung, gemeinsam den Schwur der Treue. Ich schwöre Adolf Hitler. Unverbrüchliche Treue.
Unverbrüchliche Treue.
Unbedingten Gehorsam. Sieg Heil! Sieg Heil!
In 1934, Kurt and Lotte Hartmann's oldest son, Peter, began school. Like other German boys, on his first day, he learned the mandatory German greeting, Heil Hitler. If you were an adult and you didn't use the Hitler greeting, you risked being sent to a concentration camp. So now, in public at least, it seemed as if everyone was a Nazi.
Everyone, literally everyone, cringes with fear. No letter, no telephone conversation, no word on the street is safe anymore. Everyone fears the next person may be an informer.
You're watching Third Reich, The Rise. For more on World War II, go to history.com.
Summer, 1934. Nazi Party member Adolf von Hinüber filmed this footage here on the island of Borkum in the North Sea. He and his friends were welcome at this popular vacation spot. Jews were not. For decades, the residents of Borkum proudly claimed to be free of Jews. And this year, the Nazis would set that goal for all of Germany. If you were a devoted Nazi Party member, the summer ended, as they all did, with the annual pilgrimage to Nuremberg for the party rally. For the faithful, this was the most highly anticipated event on the Nazi calendar. But the rally of 1934 would be particularly special because this year they would film the most influential piece of Nazi propaganda ever made.
What I witnessed in Nuremberg is one of the most remarkable events I have ever experienced. I cannot compare it to anything I've ever experienced before as an artist.
Mein Führer, ich melde 52.000 Arbeitsmänner zum Appell angetreten. Heil Arbeitsmänner!
Heil, mein Führer!
To capture the glory of the Third Reich, filmmaker Leni Riefenstahl helped to stage it, directing and rehearsing this scene at least 50 times.
Kamerad, woher stammst du?
Aus Friesenland.
Und du, Kamerad?
Vom Kaiserstuhl.
Und du?
Von der Donau, vom Rhein.
Und von der Saar.
Ein Volk, ein Führer.
The film Triumph of the Will premiered to worldwide acclaim, winning awards in Germany, Venice, and finally, Paris. Within a year of that award, Adolf Hitler was named Time magazine's Man of the Year.
A teacher in Dornberg had the children recite, Jews are sinners. They slaughter Christian children. They cut their throats. The damned Jewish filth. The teacher threatened to punish the children if they would not learn the poem by heart by the following day.
It was September 15th, 1935. And once again, the Nazi faithful were gathering in Nuremberg. In a speech that was broadcast to the nation, Hitler addressed what he called the Jewish problem.
Mit der Versuchung der gesetzlichen Regelung eines Problems, das im Falle des abermaligen Scheiterns dann durch Gesetz zur endgültigen Lösung der Nationalsozialistischen Partei übertragen werden müsste. Hinter allen drei Gesetzen steht die Partei und mit ihr und hinter ihr die deutsche Nation.
After these three laws were read, the halls rang with minute-long applause. It was the call of a wild animal, a beast that smells blood.
You're watching Third Reich. The Rise. For more on World War II, go to history.com.
German Reich.
It was the summer of 1936, and the world was coming to Berlin.
For Berlin, 1936 is the Olympic year, and therefore Berlin is presenting herself in festival dress. The main theme are the flags of the new party's designs, the black swastikas in a white circle on a red background.
Germany's capital was hosting the 11th Olympic Games. And the Third Reich produced tourism films like this to encourage foreigners to visit. Hitler wanted the world to see the Nazi Renaissance for itself. And so, for 2 weeks in August, the Nazis put on a show. If you were a foreign tourist at the Olympics, the Nazis might have convinced you that Germany was an open and tolerant nation. For the first time in 3 years, foreign newspapers were available for purchase. The signs prohibiting Jews from public parks or benches had been taken down. If you were German, you knew this was not Nazi Germany.